that better?
So yeah, I'm a student here at Salt Lake Community College. I'm currently finishing up my prerequisites for dental hygiene, and hopefully I'll be starting the program starting in the fall. So my talk today is titled Trust, Empathy, Morality, and Oxytocin. So a couple weeks ago, I got in a small car accident. I just got in a fender bender. The lady took some paint off my back bumper. We pulled into the Sinclair, and you know, she got out with a lot of excuses. My license just expired, and I don't have the money to pay for this right now. Can we just do this on our own? You know, not call the cops. Me, trying to be the good moral person. Oh yeah, like that's fine. And then, you know, got the quote on what it would be to fix my car, and never heard from her. So what if there was a way for me to ensure that I could trust this lady? What if there was a molecule or a hormone that could make this lady trustworthy? So before we get too crazy, let's break it down. So this is the hormone oxytocin. This is kind of an ancient molecule, and it's released in only mammals. So oxytocin is a neural hormone. So a hormone is anything, well, it's a signaling molecule that travels in your blood. So oxytocin is released from a place in your brain called your pituitary. It's specifically released from your posterior pituitary, which is also called your neural hypothesis, because having one name is just not good enough, so we need two. So a couple functions of oxytocin are smooth muscle contractions during childbirth. So like if you're going in to get induced for labor, you're pregnant, you're gonna go in and they're gonna start a Pitocin IV on you, which is a synthetic version of oxytocin. This is causing smooth muscle contractions in your uterus, telling your body, you know, we're ready to get this baby out. Also, it aids in milk letdown in breasts following childbirth. So oxytocin is also known as the cuddle hormone or your love drug. I kind of like to think of it as like your bonding hormone, because when you're doing actions or things like cuddling or interacting with someone that, you know, are kind of like those moments that help bond you to people, you're releasing this hormone. You're releasing this oxytocin hormone. So a lot of my ideas for oxytocin have come from Dr. Paul Zak. Dr. Paul Zak did the two studies I'm going to talk about today. So the first one is he brought participants into a lab, giving them $10 for doing this, right? We want to get paid for what we do, so here's 10 bucks. He took all the participants' blood before they did the study. And then he sat participants down on a computer, and you know, each one had their own separate computer. So on participant one's computer screen, it would pop up and say, hey, you have $10, right, for doing this study. You can send some of your money to someone in this lab that you don't know, you've never seen before. But the trick is the money that you send to them triples when you send it to them. So if you send $2 to them, you're actually giving them $6. And then the person that you send it to has the option of sending you money back or not. So Dr. Paul Zak said that when participants would send money, participant one would send money, that was a measure of how trustworthy they were. Because they're being trustworthy that they were hopefully going to get money back from the second participant. And then participant two, it would pop up on their screen and say, hey, some person in this lab sent you $2, but it doubled and you now have $6. Would you like to send any of that money back? And they could choose to send money back or not. So he said that participant two sending money back was a measure of their trustworthiness. Again, he took blood from the participants after they did the study. And people that had sent money or received money or sent money back, I guess, their oxytocin level spiked. So they had more oxytocin in their blood after this interaction. The second study that I want to talk about is he, again, brought participants into a lab, taking blood from them before and after the study. He showed these participants a video of a son with a brain tumor and his father that kind of had to go through this experience with him, and the son ended up passing away. And the father had to, you know, go through the grieving processes of losing a child, which would be so hard. And again, he asked his participants to write down after they watched the video how they felt. Most of them, obviously, are going to express some sort of empathy towards, the father and how, what he had to go through. Of the people that expressed some sort of empathy, again, their oxytocin levels had spiked from their second blood draw. So the cool thing, you know, maybe we understand that oxytocin, it may not be the only hormone or only molecule that has to do with this, these emotions that we're feeling, but it's a contributor. We can see that your oxytocin levels are raising after these interactions. So, you know, they're helping you feel these emotions. So the great thing about this is because we can understand what this hormone does to us, we can understand how to release oxytocin without, you know, giving us a pill or a drug. We can do it naturally, just, you know, as we are. So a couple ways of releasing oxytocin are hugging, cuddling, massaging. If you get nothing else from this today, it's that you need to go get a massage. Praying, dancing, playing with your puppy and having those interactions. Eye contact, and also positive social media interactions. So in study one, when participant one and two were sending money back and forth, they weren't actually making interactions. They weren't doing anything personally, I mean, in person, but they were still releasing oxytocin. Another thing is we understand what inhibits oxytocin, you know, what doesn't make us feel these emotions. Stress is a huge one. So for all of us students and professors that are out there, during midterms and finals week when we're a little stressed, we probably aren't releasing this hormone, and we probably aren't being very moral or empathetic towards anyone, and we're probably in a bad mood. So keep that in mind. Also, 5% of the population doesn't release oxytocin on stimulus. So maybe that's what happened with me and the lady that, you know, hit my car. Maybe even though I trusted her to, you know, hopefully pay me back and I was doing something good for her, maybe she just didn't release oxytocin, so she didn't feel like she had to return that favor that I paid for her. So in science, you are taught, question everything. You never just believe what someone tells you, right? So my challenge for you is, for the next 3 days, do 7 actions that are gonna help you release oxytocin. You know, if one of the 6 or 7 that I posted on my side wasn't something that you like, you can Google them, there's a ton. But at the end of the 3 days, or even after you do these interactions, kind of see how you feel and see if you think that oxytocin could be this moral molecule for you. And if you don't think that, what is oxytocin? Like, what is it making you feel? Is it making you more kind or not? But find out for yourself. So, and there's my sources. Thank you. Does anybody have any questions? So it makes you more trustworthy, like we talked about with the first study, and then empathy, which is, you know, feeling bad for someone, it can help with that. You know, it, and like we kind of like the slide before, how it was like it's the cuddle hormone or the love drug. This drug is released in both male and female during sex. So when you're, you know, having those feelings of emotions, you're also releasing oxytocin. So it can help you feel that emotion as well. Kristen? Meaning like, so she said 5% of the population doesn't release oxytocin. So are you asking like, why don't they, or where is it? Here we go. Well, actually, not releasing oxytocin is found in a lot of psychotic people. Like, when these 5%, a lot of them display, what's the word I'm looking for? A lot of them display attributes or have had criminal acts or something like that. So release oxytocin, people. Anything else?